They call me Gorilla Girl, but I like Diane Fossil. My life has been surprising, but let me start from the beginning. I remember my childhood with anger and sadness. My parents divorced when I was young. At age 6, I started horseback riding, where I discovered my love for animals. At age 14, I was about 6 feet tall and very self-conscious. I was an only child, so I had no siblings to play with, which was lonely, but I had animals as my companions. I graduated from high school in 1979, and started college. I developed zoology and botany, but struggled with the other classes, which forced me to flunk my second year of college. I transferred schools, changed my major, and got a degree in occupational therapy. I graduated high school in 1954. While working as a therapist, my friend invited me on a vacation to Africa. Sadly, I couldn't afford it. After that, I spent many years longing to visit Africa and realized that if my dream were to come true, I'd have to do something about it. So in 1963, I got a bank loan and made my first trip to Africa. When I got there, I spent a 7-week home tour, and when I got back, I sold pictures and articles to repay the loan. Apparently, this got Dr. Louis Leakey's attention, and he talked to me about going back to study with primates. Of course, I agreed, though my family discouraged it. I focused on learning Swahili so I could communicate. I said goodbye to my family and friends. In 1966, I headed back to Africa. I arrived in Nairobi with the basics. A man named Al Kuru accompanied me on my trip, and we headed to the Congo. On my first day of trekking, I saw a lone male gorilla setting himself. When I tried to approach, she got scared and ran away. This was my first gorilla interaction of many. While studying the gorillas in Kabara, I was kidnapped by soldiers, and once I escaped, I built a new camp in Rwanda. I found a camp Karasoki in 1974. Years later, I earned my doctorate for my gorilla research in Cambridge, England. And when I got back, I was surprised to see that the gorillas recognized me. My favorite group of gorillas is Group 4. That's the group teacher belonged to, the first gorilla to touch me. I slowly let my arm on the ground, and he slowly put his hand in mine. He seemed to be as excited as I was, as he beat his chest in victory. I spent 18 years in near isolation in Africa. I wasn't afraid to make enemies. And I disabled traps and scared off poachers. I did what I could to ward them off, but it wasn't good enough. In 1977, Digit was murdered by poachers. They cut off his head and hands as trophies. Because of this, I founded the Digit Fund to save these gorillas. They're not dangerous, they're gentle giants, and we can learn a great deal from them.
Oh, I missed!